Okay, so for the first question, we're trying to find the path of the radius of our calcium ion. And it's going to get shot out of here, like that. What we're trying to do is find the radius, right? And the radius is equal to, so we have this equation, but then we reorganized it to be that equation. And so that helps us solve for the radius. And so we just have to find these two other variables. The first one is velocity. And so velocity, we can use this equation. Energy equals 1/2 mass times velocity squared. And so we rearrange that and we get this. And so then mass is the mass of our particle, right? So right here, we have our atomic mass units, right? And then we times that by the mass of matter. Then, to find our energy, energy is equal to voltage times the charge. So our voltage is, and the voltage that's in here, in between our two plates, and that's this, 2.670. And then the charge of our particle is our charge, which for calcium, our charge is just 1, so it's just going to be this value, so it's 1.602 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. And so then we plug those in, and that gives us our energy, right? And then we throw that in this, and we get our velocity. It actually gives us velocity squared, which is nice. And so we get velocity squared, and we can throw that in there. And then we just have to find our acceleration. And so to get our acceleration, we can just use force equals mass times acceleration. So we rearrange that. And our acceleration ends up being force over mass. And so to get our force, we use the force of our magnetic field, right? Which our magnetic field is just right here, right? And so the force of our magnetic field is 0.452 teslas, right? So that's the strength of it. And our equation for telling us the force of our magnetic field is Q, which is our charge of our particle, which we find the same way. We just take, you know, the charge for calcium, this is 1, and we multiply it by the standard value for charge, which is 1.602 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. And so that gives us our charge, and then we multiply that by our velocity, which will be the square root of velocity squared that we get right there. So right there, that'll be square root of our velocity squared. That'll give us our velocity. And then the last value is just the strength of our magnetic field, which is 0.452 teslas. And so that gives us this, and then that value, once we get all those in there, that gives us our radius, which is this distance right here. Because as this comes out, right, the magnetic field is going to pull it in, right, this is going to go right there. And so it's circular, and so, yeah. The second question, that asks us to match the paths on here to the appropriate ions. Right here, I drew out all the paths, right? And so, since we've already done all this work, we know how we get our radius. And since we know that, we know kind of what goes into making them go for it. And so right here I wrote out what I was thinking, you know. So the smallest path is going to be the one that has the smallest mass and the smallest charge, right? And so the smallest mass was calcium, right? And its charge is 1, right? And so if it had like a charge of 0, like let's say we had a little particle right here, right? So if we had a little particle here and the charge was 0, right? Then it wouldn't move, it would just stay there because it can't. What's propelling it out is the fact that it has a charge, right? So if it had a charge of 0, it would just like stay there. But if it has a charge of 1, right, it'll come out. But if it has a charge of 2, right, it'll, you know, be even stronger and it'll go even farther out. And so this one would be our smallest one. So our smallest one would be calcium, right? And then the one that would go the farthest, so G, would be the one that has the biggest mass, right? Like 226 atomic mass units, right? Time with the biggest charge, right? Because it has the biggest charge, it's going to have the biggest velocity out the gate. So it's going to, out the gate, it's going to go the fastest, right? But it's also going to have, this is going to have a harder time pulling back on the particle because it has a bigger mass. So it's going, right? And if it was smaller, you know, it wouldn't be as big a deal. But since it's so big, it has a hard time pulling it back in. And so that's because when we plug the values in, right, it will be bigger. And so the biggest mass will be G, right, which is right on 3 plus. And then all of the other ones will fall in there as well. So calcium would probably be right there, you know. And then these guys would roughly, you know, kind of just go in there. Except for, you know, maybe, you know, these two are pretty close. But they would all go in and we would just solve for the radius of each of these. So we could go through and we could get the value of the radius for each one. And then we would just, you know, so we would plug in, like for the next one, we would plug in 40.1 right here. And then we would plug in right here. Instead of just having 1, we would plug in 2, right? And then, right, we would plug in 2 as well. And then we would do that, and then we could push the radius again. And then we would do that all the way down. And like, for example, for this last one, right here, 4, 3, right, we would, the number of extra electrons that it has is 3. So this would be 3, and then this would be 3. And then we would just calculate it out, you know, that'd be 3, and then our mass would be 226, right? And so once we calculated that out, we would have all of the different radiuses, right, and we would have them all on there, and they would probably look pretty similar to that. So there's question 2.